All right, let's talk about this. It looks like the Triple G fight against Jacobs is postponed to next year, so the date is open. If Crawford gets that date, who should he fight? Terrence Crawford, December 10th.
At 140, who's the other champ at 140? Ricky Burns. Ricky Burns would be a good fight, then Crawford fucks him up.
What about Chop Chop Corley?
Really, they Ricky Burns. Did he? Oh yeah, he beat him at 135 for the title. Yeah, nah, then... I don't know.
Chop's on a roll. He's like 7 wins. He's on a win streak. Yeah, he is. He has all knockouts. He sparred Lomachenko like a year and a half or 2 years ago. He did great sparring. Then he's back.
He's won like 7 straight fights. For Crawford, dude, I don't think there's a lot of competition for my 140 or a fight that I would say, oh, I want to see this fight for Crawford at 140. I think at 147 there's good fights for him. But right now at 140, I don't think there's a lot of good fights for him. The other world champ, I know the IBF is like some Russian guy. I don't know who he is. Then the other one's Ricky Burns. He already beat him. Beat Postol. Maybe a Matisse fight? I don't know. Maybe
If he's still active, we don't know.
Fighting, but I mean, that's probably the only one. But I think Matisse is moving up to welterweight. So I think he would have to move up to welterweight. And there's a lot of good fights from there with fucking Khan, Matisse.
Does anybody beat Crawford? Does anybody beat Crawford? Because he's super talented.
Right now at 140, I don't think so. At 147, there's guys that could beat him. I'm not saying that they would, but there's guys that could beat him. Like Earl Spence could beat him, Keith Thurman. These guys, those are tough fights for him. They're good fights for him. At 140, I don't think there's really a lot of competition.
I don't know. I like the way Crawford fights. But
he's bad. Southpaw orthodox. He hits hard.
I don't think anybody will beat him at 140.
Yeah, no, I don't think anybody beats him at 140. At 147 is where he'll have a lot of good fights. At 147.
147 is packed.
It'll be his third division, right? 35, 40, 47. That'd be the right there. That's good. He said he'll never fight Tim Bradley, huh?
They're best friends.
They're like best friends.
Yeah. You just heard Osvecito. For the right price, he'll fight his mom.
Yeah, that's what they think. But yeah, there's a good fight for him at welterweight. I want to see him fight at welterweight.
There are a lot of big fights in general at 47. I hope we see a lot of them next year. Danny Garcia against Keith Thurman. Who wins?
I would pick Thurman. I'll pick Thurman.
Yeah, Garcia.
Why?
Seems to always get lucky, dude.
He seems to always get lucky.
Whether it's a good left hook or good.
But that's not luck if it's consistent.
Good judging on for him or whatever. I don't know, but it just seems like he just lands that one punch or he'll get the decision when I wouldn't think he deserved the decision or something. But he just seems to always fucking win. So, but
okay.
I'll still pick them.
Amir Khan if he fights Kell Brook.
I'll pick Kell Brook.
I got Amir Khan.
Fuck. Amir Khan could box him, dude. Amir Khan for the welterweights. I mean, he moved up to 160 and fought Canelo 155, whatever.
He still was doing good.
He was still doing
until
good.
Until he got caught.
So Amir could any of the welterweights you think of, Amir fucking they'll give him a lot of trouble. He'll move around, box. I think he'll probably beat Cobra.
Against who?
I want to see Earl Spence get world title.
Who do you want to see Earl Spence fight? If you could pick one fight for him.
Crawford. Yeah, if I could just pick one fight that I want to see, Earl Spencer Crawford.
That's too early in their both careers because somebody's...
No, that's what I'm saying. It won't happen, but I'm saying if I had to pick one fight that I want to see, that I would like to see Earl Spence, I want to see him against Crawford. That's a badass fight.
Huh?
No, but I think Brooks moving to 54 now.
Yeah, but I think Brooks will be done for a while. If you really crack his eye socket, you're not coming back.
I think he'll be done for a while.
You know, everybody...
For me to think Amir Khan will probably be...
Mayweather? What's the name of that trainer who trained Bradley? The fireman.
Teddy
Atlas and another person, they all told me that the Kell Brook Triple G fight looked like it was prearranged.
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so? So why did they say?
I don't think you could do that in boxing, though. It's too much.
Too much meat?
Like, you could tell when somebody's not going as hard, and Triple G was trying to fucking kill him. The first round right away, he was swinging with everything, trying to knock him out. I don't think in boxing you could do that. Or MMA, these kind of, I mean, maybe in baseball or basketball or something, you could just fake the shot. But in boxing, you can't fake, what a real punch looks like, and Triple G looked like he was trying to go for the knockout. He hurt him right away in the first round and was going for the knockout, and then Kell Brook was punching back, and I don't think you could do that in boxing. And if you can, I think you'll be able to tell clearly, and I don't think I saw that with Kell Brook.
We could. So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, @EllieSekpak. Take a step back.